How you doing? Billy Ashbaugh here, drummerconnection.com, and today I want to share with you the Flam. Understanding the Flam and playing them around the drum set can really add a whole new dimension to your playing. It's a wonderful rudiment to explore. With that being said, there are several different exercises and or rudiments that involve the Flam that we'll be covering a lot of them in the lessons to come here, both here and out in the drum room. But I'd like to get started with the alternating Flam. And we'll look at the right Flam first. What's happening here is the right stick's going to be up higher. It's going to play the accented note. The left hand with the stick is going to be about an inch or so off of the surface, whether you're on the pad or the drum. What you're going to do is a split second before the right hand hits as it comes down to play the accented note, you're going to drop the left stick down quietly as a ghost note, and it sounds like this. So you can notice that the left stick stays low, ready to do the tap right before the accent. This is the right Flam. Now for the left Flam, reverse it. Left hand high, right hand low, tapping before the left. There's now the right staying low, and the left is doing the accent. All right, there's a look at the right Flam and the left Flam. Now I'm going to show you how to play what they call an alternating Flam, where you're just going to go back and forth from a right to a left Flam. What's going to happen is that immediately after, if we're doing a right Flam, immediately after the left hand taps its ghost note, it's going to come up to the high position to get ready for the accent for the following note. At the same time that the right stick comes down, hits the accent note, it's only going to go about an inch off of the head, getting ready for its ghost note for the left Flam. It's sort of like a trading back and forth, the motion. You'll see what I mean. So here it is. So notice a mirror image as far as the stick that's being raised from the right and the left. As soon as it taps, it raises up, getting ready for the next accented Flam. Just back and forth, no matter what tempo or how fast you play it. There it is, alternating Flam. Not that big a deal. Just get used to raising that hand up after that ghost note, ready for that next accent, and you'll be in business. Here's a little exercise that I use all the time to warm up playing these alternating Flams. I'll put the click at 80 beats per minute. You hear eighth notes clicking away. I'm gonna do quarters, one measure, eighths for one measure, and sixteenths for one measure. All alternating Flams sounds like this. Two, three, four. Flams.